Now we will discuss very important topic, which is teamwork. Two or more individuals with a high degree of interdependence geared toward the achievement of a goal or the completion of a task. Teams make decisions, solve problems, provide support, accomplish missions, and plan their work. So there is a common goal, and there are two or more individuals which are tied together, and they are interdependent, and their purpose is to accomplish the task. How is a team different from a group or a committee? Teams embody a collective action arising out of task interdependency. Members of the team agree on the goal. Members agree that they must work together to achieve the goal. Each member is viewed as having one or more important roles to play to successfully achieve the goal. There is less hierarchy within the unit than in most work groups. So the team is different from a group or a committee. In team, the people are tied together and they have to perform certain roles, and together they achieve a common purpose. There are many types of teams. Examples are athletic team, natural work group, business team, improvement team, and healthcare team. Depending upon the function they are doing or what is their objective. Understanding the group behavior. Group content. What is being said, the words and the discussion, and the group process. How the group works, methods, ways of making decisions, and how people participate. Aspects of group process communication. Who talks to whom? Who interrupts and how is it handled? How are quiet members treated? High and low participators, shifts in participation levels. Do people look at each other when they talk? How are new members treated? So these are some aspects of group processes regarding communication. And aspects of group processes regarding decision making. What process does the group use to make decisions? Is the process agreed upon by everyone? Does the process change as group proceeds? Does anyone make a decision and carry out without agreement from the others? Is there evidence of a majority pushing a decision? Are minority opinions heard? Aspects of group process problem solving. So, does the group take time to understand the problem? Is the problem well articulated? Is there time for brainstorming creative solutions? Can the group move to from problem identification, identifying possible solutions, to selecting solutions and implementation? So these are certain aspects of problem solving. Now group problem solving. Identify the problem. Generates the ideas, involve people, listen for common themes, organize the ideas, evaluate the alternatives, manage the conflict, get information, develop the plan, assign responsibilities, find resources, and then monitor the progress, motivate, details, and finish, and then a presentation. So this is a group problem solving process. Recognizing dysfunctional behavior, which is blocking, aggression, dominating, withdrawing, or out of the field behavior. Now team roles, we will discuss now the team roles, which are initiating, seeking and giving information, clarifying, summarizing, consensus taking, and accountability. Team roles relationships. Communication gatekeeping, encouraging, resolving conflict, acknowledging feelings, setting standards or norms, and finally openness. Attitudes for effective teamwork. Now, appreciation for value of team decisions, respect for the team members, mutual trust, openness to feedback, reflection on group process and interest in improving, shared vision. Now, what are the characteristics of effective teams? Members have a clear goal. The focus is on achieving results. There is a plan for achieving the goal. Members have clear roles and responsibilities. Members are committed to the goal. There is commitment. Members are competent. They possess the skills which are required to carry out their responsibilities. They achieve decisions through consensus. Not there is any type of dictatorship or dominating behavior of one person. The decisions are made through consensus. There is diversity among team members. Members have effective interpersonal skills. They know each other well and they have good relationships. More characteristics. Each member feels empowered to act, speak up and offer ideas. Each member has a high standard of excellence. An informal climate and easiness exists among members. The team has a spirit of management. The team is open to new ideas. There is periodic self-assessment. There is shared leadership of the team. The team is relatively small size. There is an optimum size of the team, which makes it very effective. There is recognition of team member accomplishments. That is sharing the credit, that the credit will be shared among the team members. Not only one person is taking the credit. This is against the teamwork. There are sufficient resources to support the teamwork. Effective team building takes time. There must be frequent and prolonged contact. Team members come together around a specific goal or a project. Effective teams go through four stages of team development.